Sometimes regular standards on cleaning glass insulators might be impossible sometimes. I might run into a wall or two, but I recently got in contact with a gentleman by the name of Patrick Scott who collects or used to collect glass insulators or acquire them, and he recently sent me these two CD133 standards, or as my favorite part, and my favorite one is this one, the number 7 standard HG Co. or Hemingray standard number CD133s. But I like the one that's the dirtiest right there because it gives me a challenge before I've been there. But I have not had any problems with cleaning glass insulators. If you remember watching my most recent video on how to clean glass insulators, and I'll leave a link that should be showing up on the screen in the upper right corner. But I was told that some of these number 7 standards might be difficult to clean, and this is the reason why he also mentioned and he wanted to challenge me. Pat Scott wanted me to see if I can clean these as much as I could, and another friend of mine told me that most of these insulators are in towns instead of on rail lines, and mostly that they're more out in the elements and more closer to where there's more dirt and emissions, or basically soot that's in the air, like for like cars and all that stuff. That's why this number 7 standard is still very black. But I was challenged to see how good I can clean these things, so I'm not going to leave a before and after results in this video. I just want to see how good I can clean these, and maybe I'll learn something on cleaning these insulators. So let's get started.